And then summit three, the unitary awakening, states that you exist simultaneously as the body, as the soul, as the transcendent self. So these states are state stages. As you emerge out of this identity with the ego into this identity in the soul transcended and included the ego, the transcendent self transcends and includes the ego and the soul. As we move into this non-dual, where we start to feel that these are not separate states, they're all in this non-dual or unitary relationship. And you know yourself as not separate from anything in reality. And a better way to say that is you know yourself as simultaneously separate and simultaneously not separate. That's why it's non-dual, non-duality, which is not the same as saying it's all one. Because non-duality takes in the many and the one simultaneously. Your transcendent self is the ultimate subject to all objects, and they are in a non-dual dynamic that is an indivisible whole. In the unitary awakening, the seer merges with what it sees. I am that. All that is you. In the unitary state, there is complete liberation and freedom from fear, even fear within the world. And there's a sense of the integration between the subject and object becoming so strong that it no longer feels like an integration, it feels like a completely inappropriate concept to even differentiate subject and object, because subjects have no meaning without objects, and objects have no meaning without subjects. And the subject and object arise as one united whole. The seer and the seen give rise to each other and define each other. And so as we access these deeper states, these enlightenment states, we find those parts of ourselves that are free, radically free. And in a lot of spiritual traditions, that's the end game. And I claim again, that's the beginning. Because if the world of form and the formless are one, then the world of form has to count. And it has to have meaning. Mm-hmm.